This is an introduction to the Harrod-Domar model, named for two economists, Harrod and Domar. The simple intuition in this model: suppose you purchase a computer. The purchase of the computer is a one-time expense. The flow of services from the computer occurs over time. The computer is a stock that generates a flow of services. Let's talk about the assumptions of the theory. The assumptions are that capital is created by investment, and this is the engine of economic growth. There are two inputs in our production process: capital and labor. We're going to define the capital output ratio as the stock of capital divided by the level of output. This is a little problematic, but we can hopefully get past this. The stock of capital is the accumulated value of all of the capital that's available, and the output is an annual or some per period level, so that we have a stock divided by a flow. Clearly, as I said, these are apples and oranges. So we have defined the capital output ratio, lowercase k, as the stock of capital divided by the flow of goods and services, GDP, in a given year. And if we can rewrite this first equation, and then we try to perform changes so that we could ask questions about how the output is changing, we can write change in y is equal to 1 over lowercase k times change in k. More to the point, though, we want to change that capital stock idea into a flow idea. The change in k is going to be defined as the rate of investment in a given year. So we're going to substitute I for change in k, or dk, and now we have dy equals 1 over lowercase k times I, the rate of investment. We're also going to assume that the country's investment comes from its savings, I equals S. Obviously, we can change that, and this is one of the criticisms of the theory. Investment doesn't have to come only from local savings. It can come from borrowed savings internationally. In any case, assuming that I is equal to S, we can substitute for I in the equation. So we have dy is equal to 1 over k times S, the rate of saving in a given year. Our final manipulation will be to divide each side by y, so that lowercase s is going to be uppercase S divided by uppercase y, and that would be the proportion of saving out of GDP, the savings ratio, and we now define the growth rate of the economy as a function of the savings ratio divided by the capital output ratio. So that is our simple idea, the Harrod-Domar model. The economy's growth is a function of its saving and the capital output ratio. I say, for example, a given stock of capital, $5,000, might yield a flow of output every year of $1,000. Obviously, we have to make changes to this model to account for depreciation and international saving to make the model more general. But that is the basic idea of the Harrod and Domar model.